On Hangout.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Activate Your Abundance. I'm your host, Shefali Burns. Thank you so much for being with us. Hopefully, my sound is okay. We were just testing it before we started, so hopefully, you can hear me okay. Let me know. Send me a message on the Q&A, just so that if we need to fix it, we can before we get started. So today on our show, we have Ma Sajady on the call with us, and I'm so excited because when Ma gets on the show, the energy is always so high, the vibration and frequency. And you guys have already sent me so many questions in the Q&A, so thank you for that. And we're going to ask Ma some of those questions for sure. So for those of you who don't know Ma, let me just tell you quickly a little bit about him. So after his second near-death experience, Ma was gifted with intuitive and healing abilities so remarkably potent it wasn't long before he was soon likened to some of the most significant healers in history. Now, thousands around the world celebrate his contribution as their realities have substantially shifted after just one or a few encounters with Ma. Beyond the usual self-help goal-setting methods, Ma works on the frequency level and opens his clients to their gifts and potentials so they can fully step into their true power. Having redesigned and reprogrammed new realities at the core level, the success rates of those with whom Ma works are high, materializing fast and tangible results and manifesting abundance in all areas of their lives. So today we're going to be talking about, for example, the real why your life has been the way it is, the real how to change your life rapidly and effortlessly, how to become enlightened without the hassle of near-death experiences, and what Ma can change your life in 30 minutes or less. So, we've had Moss on the show before, and I just absolutely love having him on the show. I love his energy, and he's so nice and compassionate and caring. It's like beautiful energy. I just love it. So welcome to the show, Moss.
Shefali, thank you. Thank you for having me. Hey, guys, how are you? It's going to be fun, I think, huh?
Absolutely. And somebody says, okay, well, so one person said the sound is great, and then another person said I sound blurry. Okay, so we'll have it's still
maybe
that way?
If you can, Shefali, just put your microphone a little further away from your mouth. It might kind of clear up the sound, although it's still kind of distant, but that might help.
Yeah, I mean, your sound is great.
It might be clearer.
But your sound is great, and really that's really what people want to hear. They want to hear you.
All right.
I'm just an added bonus, But I'll have Robert check on that.
Right, and just as a note, just for those individuals who are listening, and even on the recordings, if you listen to this recording, I'm going to be working on you guys as we speak. Okay, so you get the most out of our time. So, as a reminder, if you're driving and listening to this, not a great idea. Some people do get disoriented, so just be careful, guys.
Absolutely, and if you have water with you, drink water during the call. I think that'll really help a lot too. And so let's just get started because, we love having you talk to us. We love your energy. We love the work that you do. And absolutely, and it's like I wish we could have you more often, but, it's just like timing, right?
Thank you.
I was sincerely had thought about going to that Sedona retreat that you just finished, this past weekend. I was going to go. I was looking at the flights. I was looking at everything, but it was so close to launching the season. I was like, I just can't do it. But it's like, I want it. So I was there in spirit.
It was amazing.
Oh, I'm sure.
Sedona was fantastic. There were so many people here. We actually got overcrowded for the room.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and we did a couple free nights. One free night, and then our attendance on Friday, Saturday, Sunday like tripled.
Mm-hmm.
So we kind of had a room issue anyway. So, but we're gonna be in New York towards the end of June, so that should be interesting and fun too.
And Moss was also doing live streaming of the event, weren't you, Moss?
Yes. Yeah, more of a teleconference. We're going to get into live streaming, so it's not a video, but an audio, which is actually kind of nice because you can just kick back and relax. You don't have to watch me, but you can just listen to me, and then those frequencies, those healing frequencies that we send out or I send out, that gets integrated with you. So that's fantastic. Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah, so I just wanted to bring that up because you know, there's more to what you do than just these calls that you do, you know, all the time because you're so busy. But there's also these retreats that you do, and I would just love to come one day. I'm just putting that out there to the universe. I want to go one day.
You know, in the Sedona area, you know, there's a lot of say ascended type individuals, you know, aware individuals, you know, spiritually open. But you know, when we came in, they've never experienced the type of energy or frequencies. I mean, although there's a lot of learned individuals, I guess and it's not my point of view, but the individuals that came in, very very intrigued because what I do is very different than you know most others that are out there. A lot cleaner, purer, you know, and more efficient, basically.
So let's talk about that quickly. So this is your MOS method. Is that what you're talking about? What you do is a bit different than what everybody else does?
Yes, the method. Basically, the MOS method is that there is no method, really. You know, I don't teach you any other modality. I don't teach you any other steps or anything like that. But basically, what I do is the same thing that happened to me when I had my near-death experience. You know, I got connected to that pure source connection. And, you know, by pure source, if you're not familiar with what I do, basically another word for God or higher being or true self or, you know, whatever you want to call it. But those words have kind of been tainted, you know, and have certain stigmatism. So I use pure source. Again, the pure source that you can ever get to, you know, is what I consider pure source. You know, just connecting directly to that. And again, so what I do, I'm that guide or anchor point for you. And really, that's all I do. I bring that connection to you, pure source you, without the near-death experience.
That's
the only difference between how I got entertained by it and how you get entertained by it.
You know, I remember asking you one time, you know, how can we get what you get but without the near-death experience? And now we know this is what MOS does.
Yes.
That's wonderful. Yeah.
But if you can have a near-death experience and you know be aware of it, you know, be totally aware. I strongly urge you to. I'm not telling you to, but it is quite an experience. It's just amazing. You know, the amount of love, the joy, the peacefulness, the completeness that you are at that level. You know, you start to remember who. What we came from or who you truly are. And really, that's the only difference between me and you guys. I'm not here as a, you know, a model. I'm actually here as a model to show you guys that, you know, we're all the same. Mm-hmm. And we all come from the same place.
Absolutely. Wonderful. Thank you. Now, today we're going to be talking about 360 degrees of abundance. And, you know, you deal a lot with frequency and vibration. So, we've talked on the show before about, you know, bringing in the frequency of abundance or abundance is a state and how can we bring in these frequencies that will allow us to be in this state more so that it can start to change our physical reality because, you know, it's all nice to say right. Abundance is out there and we can have it at any time, but sometimes when we look at our bank balances, yeah, it's not showing up there, right?
It's not there.
Exactly. Not there. Yeah.
That is so true and... you know, and that's I think that's really the difference, again, on what I do. Actually, you do get, say, the physical results, whether it is, you know, the wealth abundance, the money abundance, or abundance in physical health, or spirituality, that, you know, that truer connection, that general sense of well-being, and also just that connection between relationships as well. You know, creating that closer bond, or what I call organic relationships, you know, a truer, closer bond that helps you grow. So, yes, people do get physical results out of what I do. And I think that's why I'm growing so fast as well.
I think so. Absolutely. And people, you know, some people have talked about their health, you know, or traumatic experiences that they have gone through in the past, and they would like healing for that. So you do more than just, you know, frequency for abundance, but, you know, for health and relationships and every area of anyone's life, right?
Right, definitely, and that's what covers, you know, the 360 degrees or that sphere of abundance, because you know most people who aren't wealthy, right, like the most of us here, you know, we think that we get this large lump of money, or we have a lot of money in the bank, and then we are going to be healthy. We are going to be healthier. We're going to be happier. You know, our relationships are going to go good. That's really not true. I work out with a ton of CEO type individuals, and they're no happier than people who don't have money.
Right.
So, that key component, in any physical arena, again, whether it's health or wealth or money or anything like that, it's really not about the physicalness. Because, again, a lot of people have money and they're not happy. But then there's a lot of people who don't have money and that aren't happy either. You know? So obviously it's not money that keeps you in there. In fact, some of the individuals who have a ton of money, they go start going the opposite. You hear all these Hollywood types. They get to be on drugs, because they can't handle that reality, or they, commit suicide. So again, guys, it's not the money, but it's really that connection to pure source. How pure that connection is, how clean that connection is, and how true that connection is. When that's all covered, the abundance that you want or need starts coming into you naturally. It's the secret of the secret, I say. The book The Secret, do you remember the book?
Yep.
The Secret, yeah.
We've all read it.
I think they left out a key component. But anyway, that's the secret to the secret. So that I instill in you or help you with.
Yeah, and that's something that I've always strongly believed in, that if you have that connection to to source of who you truly are, then everything else in your life will start to fall in place, I feel it does. And so it's when you work with somebody, it's not a matter of bringing in frequencies or things like that. It's to help them how to clear channels and clear areas that will help them to connect more with source.
Yes, you're kind of breaking up, Shefali.
Oh,
but
yes, sorry.
It is. Again, I don't instill anything in you. Because we are the completeness, the true light that we are. It's already there for us. Again, I don't add anything to you. What I do help you is get rid of that baggage or frequencies, I call them, or programs that run behind the scenes for you. And many of us aren't really aware that those programs are running. And these programs or frequencies or patterns, behaviors, whatever you want to call them, is that, they come from past lives, or they come from, spiritual DNA or, family type issues. So, we kind of get bogged down, and then we try to do something physical, to try to figure this out or try to remove whatever's ailing us, but it's really at a higher level frequency. Again, I delete those frequencies, and then naturally you just start shining your own light or coming into your true space, of that balance.
Okay, that makes sense to me, and I can definitely resonate with that. So today, we're talking about abundance and wealth, because that's what this show is about. So, can we talk about, for example, the wealth frequency and how that works? And so you just said you don't really instill it in people. They already have that wealth frequency. You just make it more available to them? Is that possible?
Yes. What happens, those... through the years, right, you pick up certain behavior patterns, right,
mm-hmm.
through experiences, through parenting, through parents, through schooling, through, media, the friends you hang out with, right, you create the self-image, right, and that self-image might not be the best reflection or the purest reflection of you, right? So imagine in your lifetime, all that self-image that you've created, or that point of view, and most of the time, we see that point of view is distorted. Say for example, as a child, you were, say, abused, right, or it wasn't perfect at home. You start looking at life as that's the way it actually is, and then you start living through those set of lenses, and it might have been a great tool for you to, say, save your sanity or, be protected, but then as you grow older, we still look through those lenses, and it really distorts the way we are, because that's not the trueness of how life really works. Although most of us on this call, just tapping in, think that life is the way it is because of those experiences, and again, those experiences aren't true at all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely.
Removing those patterns that we've created, or that self-image that we've created, and start shining from our harmonious place, so to speak.
Oh, I like that. Start shining from our harmonious place.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I like that too. I'll have to write that down for later.
I know, I'm writing it down right now. It's like, oh yeah. okay, harmonious place. Yeah, that was a good line.
Yeah, thank you.
So is there anything that you can do for everybody on the call with regards to abundance? Let me see, because somebody had asked a question about that, saying if you could remove, you know, whatever obstacles we have in the way of achieving, or not even achieving, attaining, or just living in more abundance.
Mm-hmm. Sure, we can do, you know, a quick meditation if you'd like. We can do that. We can talk about frequencies, whatever you want to do. It's your show. Do you want to do a quick meditation, maybe like 5 minutes or something? Or?
Sure, we could do that, or we could just take questions, because even when you're doing questions, you're still working with everybody at the same time, right?
We're still working on them. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, either way. Again, and then, you know, as we take questions, you know, I can kind of talk about frequencies or habits,
mm-hmm.
you know, wealth. Because there are certain habits. Everything has a habit or a frequency. So instilling those frequencies or allowing those to shine through, you know, and deleting, say, the negative ones or the ones that aren't as productive for us. Yeah.
Okay. So before we...
Yes, definitely. You can do that.
Yeah, so before we get to the calls, I have a quick question for myself. It's like, this is why I love it when you come, because, like, I always have something. It's like... So sometimes what happens with me, and this may happen to other people too, so I'm not hoping that it happens to them, but I'm hoping they can relate to it in some way. But you know how I work with a lot of healers and energy workers, right, on the show, and separately as well on my own personal time. I work with a lot of healers as well, and sometimes what happens is when there's an energy download, right, like there's a meditation, there's a lot of energy work happening, I end up getting these really severe headaches and neck aches, you know, and I know it's the energy, you know, so like this happened last night, you know, right after my call, and it's like, oh, you know, and then this morning it was still there, and it's like, that's what it is, and I know what it is, I just am not able to, I hate to say that word, but I'm not able to, like, fix it on my own, and I don't want to take Advil or something because I know it's just an energy thing, and, you know,
mm-hmm.
Can you help with that?
Sure. Just to kind of clarify, Shefali, you know, when you say, you know, it's an energy thing, I mean, really, any headache or any physical issue is an energy thing, and that's, you know, most people try to solve it at the physical level, but you're right, there is an energy, you know, that frequency, I call it, you know, the spiritual frequencies. There's obviously physical frequencies that are around. You know, I deal with the spiritual frequency, you know, higher up. So once you start changing those, then, you know, the physicalness of what we have disappear a lot easier. But just, do you get headaches when I work on you too? Or is it everybody? Or any type of energy? Or?
Yeah, it's most energies. Because I, you know, maybe my channels are not as clear as they should be, and there's so much energy coming through, or, you know, I'll keep it short. I mean, it's usually at the back of the neck and the top of my head, you know, like all around the head area, and it's like.
Right. Yeah, I see that. Let's see if I can clear it out, you know, while we're working or talking.
Fantastic.
We'll do that and maybe kind of realign you.
Thank you. So this is the kind of work that Maz does. You know, within a few minutes, he will work on you and realign stuff, and it can change more than what I've just asked for, you know, because once you become realigned, other stuff happens, right? You're more available to other stuff. You're more allowing and being able to receive more, right, from the universe?
Yes. Yes, definitely. So true.
Yay. Okay, so we're gonna go to Santa Rosa, California, and see what question they have. Area code 707. I'm gonna unmute you. Hello.
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 Hi.
Yes. Hi.
Oh, hi. I wasn't expecting to get picked. Moss, I'm actually working. My name is Consuelo, and I'm actually in your 21-day program.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, and
are you liking it?
Yes, I am liking it. I'm away from home. I'm on the road traveling, so I'm doing the best that I can to stay in tune and to be able to attend both of the meditations. And I had the good fortune of seeing you at your San Francisco event that you did and got some with you. And, gee, I really wasn't, I still wasn't even sure that it was me that had been selected for this call. But, you know, I just, I'm hoping that I feel that the work that you do is the real deal and that you're connecting us to the source. Because, you know, I'm kind of at my wit's end. I've tried so many things, and I've been trying to hang in there and believe, but things are just not changing on a outward level. And, you know, all I'm really wanting is that pure, that connection to pure source.
Yes.
And also, if there's one other, thing real quick I can ask you is, you know, I had surgery for an enormous cyst on my liver, and I had gone to someone that said that they had healed it and it wouldn't, I wouldn't have a problem with it, and I think it's coming back again. I have to go for tests in the next few days, and I'm wondering, can you work with my frequency so I don't have to have that invasive surgery again?
Sure, we can see what works out. Again, you know, I can't guarantee anything for you, and again, I'm not a doctor or of any fashion.
No, I understand. Yeah,
we can. Let's go back and talk about some of the things that you said, because what I see is actually, you know, I think since the San Francisco deal, because of these 21 days, what I see you kind of compartmentalizing things. Have you been going through thoughts, things like that, kind of wondering about certain issues, right? Probably more the base level type issues, because I see that kind of dropping out, but you're still holding on to them at some level. So that's why you might not see, say, the physical changes, and I kind of see things kind of getting a little worse for you. Past, say, month or so, right? Or you're more into your, and it's not that it's worse for you, but actually, in reality, it's come front and center for you. Because before, you always say, put it aside and thought that you're trekking in the right direction. But what's happening now, you know, is in reality that all those things that have been around you, all those things that you've kind of like worked around, basically, over the past 20 years or so, are coming front and center, so you become aware of it. And that's why I say it might have actually gotten worse for you, you know, since the San Francisco event. Is that fair to say, right?
Well, yeah, things are kind of coming to a head, and
yes, and that's what needs to happen for you to break free, because, you know, you hold on to things a lot, well, more tighter than most individuals. Uh-huh. Right, probably from that fear space. So it is going to take a little longer. The best thing I can suggest is being consistent, because you are, like you said, too ahead. It's the final climax, you know, before like the end of the play. You know how everything gets more exciting at the end, and then it just drops down. That's the point that you're at. So I would do what you're doing. Be consistent, because you are at a breaking point.
Okay. Well, I hope it's going to break for the on the good side.
Oh, that's what it's there for.
Okay.
Yes. And as we leave her, guys, just as a note, there's about maybe 40-50% when I work on individuals, they just go forward. You know, they go into the new realities. The other 40-50%, what happens to them is they have to, say, let go of things. You know, they have to, it's just like a physical detox, you're going through this spiritual detox, you know, of letting go of things, letting go of past behaviors, patterns, you know, because we expect to change, then we don't want to change for new things to come into play, and that's what's happening for you. You're just holding on.
Okay, so
but
just
either
keep
way,
the
you'll
program. Yeah, just keep doing the program with you and just keep on keeping on, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Thank you so
Definitely.
Much. Thank you for taking my call. Okay. And thank you for all that you do. Yeah, okay.
Thank you, Consuelo.
Thank you.
Okay, so I have to tell you, Mas, you're obviously doing something because I've already started yawning, like, big time. So which means I'm releasing, you know?
Nice.
Yes, I just thought I'd mention that out there because everybody knows I yawn, and I just yawned into the camera without even realizing. It's like, So yeah, it's true. You know, I like what you said, that for 40-50%, they just start moving forward in their lives and they start to see results. But then the other 40-50% that need to start letting go. And sometimes we hold on to stuff because we are afraid of the unknown, right? We don't know what the future is going to be, or we're control freaks and we just want to have everything in place before we take that first step, right?
Right. Yes. And again, you know, sometimes, you know, I work on individuals and they go, Moss, you know, you have to work double hard on for me to help release. And it's not really up to me. It's really up to how your rule sets have been created, mm-hmm. or how you hold on to things, or how you want to control things, either out of fear of, you know, letting go, or a fear of succeeding. You know, either way, you know, it's the thing is on your side. But I know for a fact that if you become consistent with what we do, you do start to release. So,
okay, perfect. Now, I have a comment, an interesting comment on the Q&A that came in before we started from Cindy. So I thought this was so cool. And so she's asking a question. Have you come to me in a dream as a Catholic priest with Egyptian eyeliner? It was about 5 years ago, and in a church, she came to me with the question, what do you want? And my response was wanting to become more spiritual. Then with your right hand fingertips together, you briskly connected to my heart chakra, and then I slipped into the sleep of being in the spirit. Profound. It's like, wow.
Wow.
Yeah.
So she had a dream about me?
Exactly. It was definitely you, yeah.
Oh. Yeah, okay. You know, that's really interesting because you know, a lot of people have kind of coming forward and saying, you know, they have had dreams about me.
Hmm.
And basically, it's the same scenario. Obviously not the Egyptian with the eyeliner,
mm-hmm.
although that would be kind of cool. Maybe in my next event, I'll come as that. but maybe that's what you, say, are familiar with. Mm-hmm. Or maybe, who knows, maybe I helped you in a past lifetime. You know, that could happen too. But most likely, whatever you're familiar with, you know, I work on, you know, on stage when I work on individuals, you know, it's the coolest thing to hear. You know, if you are, say, of a Christian bent, you know, they say, you know, wow, this was really the coolest thing because you just faded and then I saw Jesus come through and work on the individual, you know. And then if they are of, say, some other bent or spiritual bent or, you know, the Buddhist type, you know, it's like, wow, you faded through, and then I saw Buddha come through.
Wow.
So it's really dependent on although those are a few of my spirit guides, you know, it's mm-hmm. really according to your experiences on how you relate, you know, with what it means to your spirituality. And that's really, again, another difference of me. I don't try to put you into another arena. I just enhance whatever arena that you are and just enhance it into, you know, that pure source connection. I don't teach you another modality, any modality if you are a healer. I just help you enhance it better, whether you're a Reiki person, whether, you know, you're Western medicine or even if you're a business individual. You know, I help you, say, get in or connect to that higher realm of your business.
Yeah, that was one of the other questions I had, because, you know, obviously I'm in business, right? This is my business. Mm-hmm. So what is a success energizer, and how do you energize business success?
Success energizer, somebody called me that. It was kind of cool. It was kind of related to that bunny. Was it the Duracell bunny?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, that's where the name got coined from. But yes, success does have like different habits, different frequencies. You know, every frequency that we have, every frequency, say, that gets instilled in us starts resonating, and then it creates density, or, you know, the physical reality, or, you know, what we call materialization. So instilling frequencies from, say, another successful individual into you, or just general frequencies of wealth, you know, then you start operating from that frequency. And that's, you know, and wealth starts coming or attracting towards you. It's very easy. You know, they interviewed Donald Trump, and they asked, you know, was it because your father was wealthy, or was it because, you know, your father was in real estate that you're so successful? And he kept saying no to all this stuff. Hmm. He goes, but the only thing he attributed his wealth was, it's that it's in his lineage, meaning that he naturally, like, he comes from that frequency of wealth, you know, in that family. And in certain families, right, there's a frequency of being poor.
Uh-oh.
So, you know, generation after generation after generation, you know, what happens, we're poor. But, you know, the nice thing is, Shefali, is once you're aware of it, you can change the frequencies that you have as a default frequency.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Hmm. Interesting.
You know, and resonate like Donald Trump or whoever that you want to resonate like.
Okay, because, you know, like a lot of people, you know, in their backgrounds, they have, you know, like hardworking, challenging backgrounds, generations, right? And so for them, it's hard to make a lot of money, right? It's hard to be successful because that's what, you know, that's what they have in their lineage. And interesting. I never thought of that. Woo! That's an aha moment there. But we can change it. I like that. I like that you said that we can change that.
You can change it. You can change anything that you want. You know, in this reality, people come up with these ideas of, like you said, you know, you have to work really, really hard to make a lot of money. I mean, that's a frequency that resonates for you. If you truly believe that, that's what's going to be true in your reality. You know, a lot of us have come up with the idea that, you know, if you are wealthy, you know, you're not going to be close to that pure source, right? Or go to heaven, right? Because money is greedy. I mean, the wealthy is greedy. All those things that are associated to money. Well, you know, that's why we are where we are. You know, money just comes into us just like any other pure source gift. Mm-hmm. You know, money is just like anything else. It's nothing special. It still comes from pure source, just like the water you drink, the air you breathe. Yeah. It's just another commodity, basically.
So if I wanted to be as successful as Oprah, I can just bring in that frequency. I can say, okay, please bring in the frequency of success such as successful as Oprah is. Can it be as simple as that?
No. It's really, because most of us can't get into what I call, you know, your base or your core or your blueprint. Let's call it a blueprint. You know, the core blueprint or that spirit level design that was created for you. So at some point, you know, you decided to come into this physical realm. You know, you created a blueprint or something to go off of. You know, you probably picked a lot of it off from your family lineage, right? Mm-hmm. But that's what resonates in you. So if you can go into that admin level programming and then do that similar to what I do, then yes, you will turn into whatever, you know, resonates at that level.
Okay.
And we've had people do that. So my abilities aren't as strong, so I can't help you do it instantaneously, but, you know, rather quick. Things start to change for individuals.
Yeah, I mean,
it's all really up to you.
It doesn't have to be instant. It can be a gradual process. I mean, it can be one step at a time, because sometimes even our physical realities are not ready for that instant change, you know?
Yes,
that could
definitely
be a block right there, but it is what it is. It's true. Sometimes, you know, physically I may not be ready to be Oprah, you know. It's like I wouldn't be able to handle the popularity and the celebrity status, and I don't have bodyguards and things like that. So yeah, I couldn't handle it right now, but gradually, you know, sure we could do it.
Yes, gradually. Yes, and I think that's why some of the stuff that we do, again, you know, you have to form into that. Although it's probably starting for you or happening for you already at spirit level, you know, mm-hmm. when I work on you, but there's a lag time. Because, again, like you said, you have to get comfortable into that space or grow into that space.
Yeah, and I just want to point that out for the listeners so that, yeah, you know, yes, sometimes it may not seem like anything is happening fast for you, but it, you know, if you keep at it, if you still stay positive, if you still connect to source on a regular basis and have that intent of what it is you want, it is moving there. You know, you are moving into that space more and more the more you do it. But if you suddenly have thoughts and feelings of doubt, or this doesn't work, or why did I do this, what a waste of money, blah blah blah, then yeah, you're gonna go downwards, right? You're gonna go backwards.
Yes, and you know, I'm not so sure about being in your positive space because you know some of the detox that people go through, obviously anxiousness, anxiety, you know, so those emotions aren't there for you to run away from, but actually to be aware of them. So highly suggest, you know, if you're feeling depressed or anxious, you know, or you know, afraid, you know, really look into those emotions, you know, really feeling and being, and then you'll find that in reality, you actually step out of them a lot faster than trying to run away from them, because then it always comes back to you. But once you've experienced that reality of being anxious or whatever it is, you can walk out of it a lot easier.
Yeah, absolutely. Fantastic. Thank you. All right, so we're now going to go to Tulsa, Oklahoma, maybe? Area code 918. Okay.
Yes.
Hi.
Hello. Hi.
Is this Karen?
Oh. Yes, this is Karen. Sorry, my phone is ringing. I've had a situation and this has been going on really strong for over 4 years. Before I would pay people for services, and then they wouldn't do them. And then also, basically, they'd rip me off. And then I helped people and helped people and helped people. And then they would turn around and steal from me. And I'm wondering what you might see that might be going on there and how it could be stopped.
Do you see how that happens, guys? It's just, again, a frequency that resonates inside you. And then you start creating, you know, issues or experiences that make that true. You know, and it really kind of goes back in your family space. Not exactly sure, but do you have like heartburn or something similar to that in that area?
No.
Or something going on?
No.
On that left side? Right? Kind of like the ribs, spine area? Because in that area, I see this family. It's like your family is connected to you somehow. And it distorts you, and it's not the best feel. It's that stabbing you in the back type feel that I get from your family that might have come through. I don't know if it's your current family now. It's kind of like that. But that's that feeling that I get. And it's amazing that you don't have any physical issues in your back because it's like you've created a past life experience of, or maybe you died from a past life of being stabbed in the back. But if you're running with that frequency, you know, in this lifetime, then you attract things that feel like you're being stabbed in the back, basically.
Well, my father's dead, my husband's dead, and I live in another state. I'm not around family, and I'm also adopted, so I don't really know about maybe some of the family.
Yes, so it's amazing. Again, you don't have any physical issues.
I've actually even had a heart attack before, a few years ago, but you just said heartburn, and that wasn't one of the symptoms.
Yeah, right in that area.
Yeah.
No, right in the, in the middle of the chest, you know, that whole general area. So maybe that's kind of where it comes from. Again, let's see if I can help you remove that, and that's what I've been trying to do. Your
Thank
family,
you.
Like I said, well, even being adopted, somebody gave you up for adoption, you know, you might have that as being stabbed in the back. It's like, why didn't, you know, your parents take care of you? You know, that kind of feel, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So, how are you feeling? Different, the same, not sure?
Well, I feel excited about getting to talk with you.
Oh, thank you, hon. How does that heart space feel?
I feel more open.
Good. It's a good start.
Okay.
So we'll continue to work on you. We can move on, Charlie, but I'll work on you. And
okay,
if you can,
thank you so much.
kind of right in.
Bye.
Yes.
Okay,
thank you, Karen.
You're welcome.
And again, Karen, write in, you know, a couple minutes, see how you feel.
And, you know, sometimes that is the beginning, just feeling lighter, feeling more open, you know, and then if you can continue to focus on that more and more throughout the day, next dates, and so on, you will continue to feel this presence, you know, this Moss's presence and his energy working. I think that's what that's what I think. Moss, what do you think?
Mm-hmm. Definitely. Or, you know, Karen, it could be that, I don't know if your husband or father had died with some chest-type issues. You know, sometimes people, because I do see family members in that space, sometimes they're integrated in you so much, especially if you've been taking care of them as they've been crossed, you know, when they're ill, and then they cross over. Sometimes they don't cross over into that light, that heaven space. They actually just integrate into you. So that chest pain that I might be picking up is actually might be from, again, your husband or father. That's integrated in you.
Okay, so I have a question from Regina on the Q&A. And she says, I have many multidimensional gifts which are sporadically showing up for me, but they are never constant, which makes me unsure of what my true healing or multidimensional gifts are, and even what I'm truly meant to do with them. Can you please help? This is Regina from Oregon, I think.
Yes. Yes, with Regina, you know, I think she's actually transformed quite a bit. She sounds familiar to me. She has transformed quite a bit, opening up to her gifts in later this summer, or, you know, closer to fall. Perhaps she starts getting into, you know, a clear path of what she's supposed to do. And then also, during that time, she starts to realize that this is a great example of individuals that, you know, hold on to the status quo and then wanting something a little different to show up in their lives. So, you know, thinking of the true things in life, or thinking of how those patterns become true. Those things that we think are true in life, or what makes life real, guys, aren't really true. It's just another frequency that kind of distorts you. So, Regina, once you let go of that, you actually start coming in, and it seems like you're going to let go, you know, during the summer. Coming into fall, you'll start to see a clearer path. So.
Wonderful. Thank you. So, now we're going to go to Massachusetts or Maine? I think Massachusetts. area code 508.
Hi, this is Amira.
Hi, Amira.
Hi, Amira.
Oh, this is wonderful. Thank you so much. I have a slew of abundance issues going way back generations, but it's affecting me right now because I'm a concert pianist and I severely injured my finger in September. I had to cancel all my concerts until recently, and I'm playing the Ravel Concerto this Sunday, but my finger is still quite problematic with my third finger of my left hand and my second and first joints, and it's affecting my whole arm and shoulder. So unfortunately, even though I can play the Ravel, I'm playing in pain, and if there's anything you can do to shed some light or insight on this, I would be most grateful.
Yes, what I see, I don't know if it's physically an attribute, but is your right shoulder higher than the left?
I think it is now because of the injury.
Okay. Yeah, I kind of just see that. And then the left shoulder, it's almost like it's weighted down by something, you know, as if you had like a weight on your shoulder. See what that's about. Because that distorts your physicalness, you know, your physical, the bone structure, and then the nerves going into your hands, they get pinched in the neck area from what I'm seeing.
Yeah, my neck's all pinched, but my finger got caught in my dog's leash when he lunged at a rabbit, which tore the ligaments and tendons.
Okay. Yes, work on that to help you heal faster.
I definitely feel some tingling going around my third finger right now.
Good. I see a lot, again, you know, obviously the physical injury of the leash, but a lot of tension in the neck area, you know, being compressed. So really opening that up. And that's why you're feeling that circulation in the finger. You know, if your nerves are squeezed, you know, it's just like sleeping on your arm. You know, it goes numb. And then if you do have an accident or an injury, it takes a longer time to heal just because the nutrition isn't going in there. So,
is there some reason why this I have this physical block in my neck?
Sure, your mother just weighs you down quite a bit. It's almost like a debt that you owe her. I don't know if that's physical. It's in this physical realm, but that's what I see. It's kind of like this debt that you owe somebody or you brought in. Does that make sense to you? Although
yeah,
it might
I mean,
not be your real debt. Go ahead.
She was incredibly abusive to me as a kid, and I had a very hard time, and I left home when I was 16. But I've recently, I was talking to my daughter the other day, and I actually was defending my mother and actually felt compassion for her for the first time. I'm kind of feeling I'm healing. I mean, I do probably owe my parents some money. They've been helping me out since my divorce. So it could be that physical debt, or it could be something from a past life. I don't know.
I think it's probably, you know, all of the above, because again, your mother feels like there's a debt that has to be repaid, and it goes back more than this lifetime, you know, it just seems like a something that just came in, and that's why you always feel like you have to repay her or owe her back, even if it wasn't, you know, the actual money, but that's why you're in the situation that you're in as well, you know, because of the money, so. Does that make sense? You attract that debt experience.
Yes, and I'm certainly increasing that. Do you have any advice on how to shift that or release it?
Yes, and I can do that for you. Obviously, you can do it if you had access, you know, once you become truly aware. But yeah, that's what I'm working on now.
Well, thank you.
Just removing that debt or, you know, tearing up that contract. You know, some people call it a contract. Just tearing that up, releasing you of the debt. Your mother is going to probably feel different too from this. She might actually start to say be more abrasive to you to try to get control over you, because now that control feature is gone.
Oh, okay.
So just kind of be aware of that. Just if she does that or when she does that, just don't interact with it. Just let it be. Let her, you know, yell or whatever she needs to do. And don't interact, and then that way you get completely disconnected. So, how are you feeling? How's your neck, shoulders? Do you feel more aligned, straighter? You'll start to
I
see
feel,
your physical body adjust too. But.
I feel lighter. There's less density or heaviness around my shoulders and neck.
Yes, that's the debt that was removed from you. So your physicalness, whether you come back to me, you know, in a session or go back to a chiropractor, you'll see that you're going to adjust a lot easier. Things are going to move and stay there a lot easier because the actual frequency that caused it is removed.
Right.
And I bet you're going to heal a lot faster, too.
That would be wonderful. Thank you so much.
Yeah. You're welcome.
Thank you, Amira.
Thank you.
All right.
So, Paula, do you see how that works? I mean, you know, most people think that she's, okay, like, if you went to a chiropractor, they'd go, oh, you've got shoulder issues, it's distorted. But, you know, if you really look at the picture, she actually had, like, this weight of debt. You know how debt just weighs you down?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
You know, it's the physical density, and it's so real when you create those frequencies that her shoulder, her left shoulder, was, you know, getting heavier or a lot lower than the right because that's where the weight was. So
and
it does create physical issues for you.
And sometimes we don't know that, you know, so we have these physical issues, we don't know what's going on, and then we realize it was caused by something else, right? It wasn't really anything that was, you know, caused on the physical
right.
level. Or can it bring about those physical experiences because of the frequencies? Because frequencies come in first, right? And then the physical happens, right?
Oh, yes. Oh, definitely, yeah. It always comes in first. I mean, just in her example, you know, if there's this debt on her shoulders. Mm-hmm. She said, you know, she has multiple abundance issues. Well, that's why she'll never be in the abundance field, because, you know, the frequency is, of debt is running in her.
Yeah.
So she probably owes more than her mother, you know, other individuals or whatever it is, banknotes or whatever it is. But anyway, those frequencies of debt won't allow anything else to come in. So once you remove that. Another clear example, I guess, is people who pack, you know, who keep knickknacks around, they can't get rid of anything. You know, I see that at a spirit level, that they're kind of distorted too much, they're holding on to too much. And then, you know, I clear them out at a spirit level, and this happens all the time. You know, after about a week or so, people come up to me or email us, and they go, you know, Masa, I've been trying to clean out my house forever. And today I woke up, I had this energy, and I threw everything away.
Nice.
So at spirit level, they got cleared out. So it has to show on the physical level. It has to be equal.
Okay, that makes sense.
You know, oh, again, they've been trying for 20 years to clean up their apartment, but that's the reason why.
So that can be something really small that, you know, we don't realize, you know, why we're holding on to these things, you know, and then suddenly Moss changes something in you and you suddenly are clearer and lighter, right? And it's in the spirit level and then it shows up in the physical. Oh, I like that. Yeah.
Yes, definitely.
So I have a question from Lori on Facebook, and she says, you're awesome. And she wants to
know.
Yeah. Okay, she wants to know, what has been going on in my lower abdomen? This has been on and off for about 3 years. And when will I return to a place where I am earning an income, whether it be going back to a JOB or if I will do something different than that? There has been a lot going on with me, so I would love to hear your input. And if you need more info, you can type it in.
Mm-hmm. Actually, from what I'm seeing, she's really... kind of taking inventory of where she is right now, which is really nice. It seems like she do go back to a job type deal, but it's very short. It's very short-lived, and then you find, your, let's say, like your true calling or what you really enjoy, from what I'm seeing. But I think maybe, again, from the work that we've kind of done, you're taking stock of what you want to hold on to. So if you can type in if that's accurate or not, and letting go of those things that aren't really serving you, that's the level that you're at. Okay, so it's really nice. You know, when you let go of those things, then that abundance, those abundance frequencies are flow into you easier, and that's where I see you heading out on your path. And it doesn't really take long, really, for you.
And so she'd also asked, and why am I unable to lose weight? Is that because she's still holding on to stuff, and when she starts to let go of stuff, the weight will also start to drop off?
Yes, definitely, because when I see her, she's got all these things, like, around her, you know, literally, like, wrapped tight or wrapped around her. So when she starts to let go of that baggage, you know, again, because those frequencies have to create the density of width, you know, to hold her in. But physically, she has to expand to hold that in. I've seen people lose, you know, 50, 80 pounds without changing their diet. And all they've done is just let go of junk.
So for people that are... Me, I'm feeling great, actually, you know? It's like lighter, you know? And no pain, you know, I'm feeling good. Feeling fantastic. Because I also allowed, you know, it's like, I'm just going to allow Moss to do what needs to do, what he needs to do so that, you know, I can be clearer, right? Lori says, yes, you are correct. I already forgot what you said,
yeah.
But you're correct.
Very nice.
So that's good. Okay, do you have time for one or two more questions?
Sure.
Okay.
Yep. Yeah, one or two more, and then
We're going to go to Oregon. I think, oh no, no, we're not going to go to Oregon. What am I talking about? We're going to go to Wyoming, sorry. Wyoming, area code 307.
Yes. Yes. Hello.
Hi.
Oh my goodness, thank you for picking me out of your brain. Okay, Moss, this is round three. I'm Kat.
Round three? Oh, round hey, Kat, how are you?
Hi. Hi. Okay. I get that you were kind of talking about me the whole time through this whole call. I am freaking out right now. That is so awesome. With the back issues and all that, I don't understand. I manifested my dream job. And with the whole backstabbing vibe, there it goes. You know.
Yeah, I do see, like, I don't know if you have a curvature, like, in your mid-back or something. Do you have mid-back issues?
I have lower back issues. I'm missing two discs in my back.
Okay. I can't. Does that curve your mid-back for some reason?
Yes. Well, it's because I'm tall. I slouch to fit in.
Oh. Okay, so that's the curvature in your spine. I haven't gotten, like, that far down. But, yeah, I do see the lower back issues, too. But the mid-back issues is really more of a frequency type. You know, when you slouch down or whatever to conform, say?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So let's get rid of that frequency. The nice thing that I see, Kat, is that, again, probably from the work that you're doing, is that frequency is actually on the outside of you. And maybe before, I don't remember because I talked to so many people, but, you know, before it probably was integrated into you or in your body, but now this, mm-hmm. this form is outside of you, which is really kind of cool. So it's ready to leave. So you're at that level. You're probably here, and that's why she probably picked you, because I can help you remove that. So you just remove that space faster. You know, the amazing thing is, guys, whatever you need starts to come into you. Whether, you know, doctor, people, individuals, places, things, remedies, you know, they naturally, again, start coming into you for you.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense, Kat? And that, I think that's true of your experience, right?
Oh, it is, because it perpetually happens that way. You know, I mean, it was. Yes. I love that job. It's what I always wanted. And then there's this group of mean girls and the backstabbing, and I'm back to what I'm familiar to with a job, but...
Yes, and let me explain what happens on that. This happens to, sometimes, you know, in the job, the wealth scenario, and then also in relationships as well. You know, we release and then we re-attract whatever, say, that distorted relationship that we attracted before. And it's not because it didn't work or anything, but it's because at a physical level, you mentally said, wait, this isn't going to work because I know it's going to lead me into that same dark cavern that I was,
exactly.
Right? And then you back away
from
it. So you're actually in a good place. Those things aren't supposed to work out for you. You'll see that another job comes up for you and another relationship comes up for you as well, which is going to be a lot better. But these things were there for you to physically be aware and then back away.
Really?
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
It happens
I'm
all the time.
Conscious.
Cool.
I'm conscious of it now and I can see it.
Yes.
This particular
and you see it right away, right?
Yeah.
You see it right away rather than like 6 months into the relationship and you go, God, you know, it's the same kind of type of person that beat me up or, you know, distorted.
Like I get to be the punching bag again. Yeah. I don't.
And see, that won't happen. You know it instantly as soon as you connect with somebody. So those are there just to help you realize at a physical level what's going on for you. Okay?
And I
it's
think,
not like you're getting directed to that. Awesome.
Yeah.
You're in
a
great
lot
place
more.
To yes. You're in
so
a great
it's letting
place.
Loose.
Yep. You're just,
right?
You're in that learning curve. And your learning curve is actually kind of short, which is fantastic.
Really? So things are going to let up and get better. I just need some encouragement, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. You're on that path. That's good.
It'll all work out, Kat.
Yes.
Okay, awesome. All right, thank you so much. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, hon. Thank you.
Thank you, Kat. Okay, so Lori... commented back and saying, can you remove it? So I think normally when Moss is working on somebody, and even if people are asking questions on the Q&A, you are actually removing things and aligning things anyway. So yes, Lori, he is removing it.
Yes. Yeah, when I'm talking about it, it means that I'm working on it to release it and bring you back into your harmony. Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Absolutely. Okay, last question. Now we are going to Oregon, area code 503. Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. Hi.
Who's this?
It's me.
Hi, me.
Who's this, son?
Regina?
Oh, my goodness. I'm like, is that me? I thought I was, hi, Ma. Hi, Shefali.
Hi.
You just answered my question on the webcast, but I just wanted to tell you, Moss, I did feel that something pivotal was going to happen to me in June that was going to make me shift exponentially. And I already came to that conclusion. We talked one time about the bridge, that I had to go across the bridge. And,
yes,
and I felt that it was going to happen when I was in Spain. So... Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's fantastic. Yeah, as you cross that bridge, you're not carrying the baggage that you normally carry with you.
Yeah, and I kind of knew that. I mean, we talked about that, and I said I know I was meant to go across the bridge, and I just kind of knew that it was going to happen. And I did cry when I thought about it, because it was going to be releasing a lot of stuff that I know that was familiar to me, and I did that. But then I really, when I did let the cry go, I really accepted it. And I said, you know, whatever happens, it's going to be beautiful because I'm going to be in Spain. My God, you know?
That's
right. Yeah. So, and you know, I wanted to tell you thank you, but I just wanted to confirm that, yes, I felt like there was going to be a big change for me this summer. Mm-hmm. So.
Fantastic. That's awesome.
And, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Regina. All right, so, so Moss has a new package, or it's new to me, and let's just bring it up. It's at activateyourabundance.com/Moss, M-A-S, so it's activateyourabundance.com/Moss, M-A-S. We're just going to bring it up here. So
yeah, if you can read that package, Polly, I don't have it in front of me.
Yeah, okay, I can do that. All right, so it's the Be Limitless, Change Your Life, Change Your Frequency, Change Your Life, the Pure Source Frequency, and we're talking about how to set affirmations that really work. That's one of the programs on here. It's a 60-minute MP3 where it's a talk in frequency medi-healing. And we didn't talk about medi-healing during the call, but because I knew we were going to talk about it here.
Yeah, the medi-healing, it's a term that I coined. It's where, you know, I get you into a nice, deep meditative space. And this goes beyond, you know, if you've done meditations for 20 years or if you're just starting out, I guide you into that meditation. People who have done it for 20 years or so, you know, they go much deeper. But anyway, as I guide you in, I work on you at that admin level or that blueprint level. So while you're working on your body, I'm working on that spirit space, you know, and combining that, you know, that's how people get the transformational events that they, you know, they feel or experience with me a lot faster. So that's what that meta-heal is.
I'm losing you. Here I am. And the next one is the frequency spa for weight loss and eating disorders.
Mm-hmm. That one is really interesting. You know, we did that. We did the call on that. And, you know, a lot of people try to lose weight, but then they have that yo-yo effect, and it's really hard for them, you know, to keep the weight off or just take the weight off completely, you know, or initiate that process. But, you know, we go into the reasons why you're holding on to that weight. And a lot of times, you know, there might have been abuse, there might have been, you know, you're fearful, or you might have been attacked as, you know, a woman. And you keep the weight to protect you. So, you know, getting rid of the reasons why and then putting in a new protection layer for you, a healthier protection layer, and that way it'll allows you to lose the weight. And, you know, and then you also get attracted to the better foods,
mm-hmm.
you know, to help you lose weight. So it's not a willpower issue. You naturally start to you know, attract foods that are better for you, and then detract foods that aren't that great. They just won't taste as good for you.
Right. And the next one is conquering the mind, healing fear.
Hmm. Oh, that's a big one.
Yeah.
Most of us, you know, they're fearful of what I find is that they're fearful of success, you know, because they've never maybe experienced the good things in life. You know, maybe they think they don't deserve it, or people think that they don't deserve it. You know, whatever it is, you know, getting rid of that fear and allowing fear to actually help you. You know, because fear is not a negative tool. It's actually supposed to be there to guide you and protect you and then help you go forward. So, you know, transforming fear into power.
I like that, because we all have, you know, fears that are, because if there's something blocking us from what we truly would like to experience, it's the fear, right?
Yes, definitely.
And then the next one we have, rejuvenating the body, anti-aging.
That is really cool. That's part of the frequency spot, I think, rejuvenating or anti-aging. And, you know, we came out with that because I do a lot of work in the LA area, and, you know, they're a little more, say, physically, you know, conscious. So they go to the spas a lot, and they have these spa treatments. And what these women were finding out after they've had a couple sessions with me, you know, the spa treatments seem to last, like, you know, 3 to 4 times longer than normal. So we figured, which was a cool side benefit.
Mm-hmm.
So we figured, well, what if I actually focused on the anti-aging? People have gotten phenomenal results. They look younger. You know, they look prettier from the inside out.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so you start looking more vibrant, more thriving, you know, from the inside out, which actually, you know, exudes, you know, through your pores, and you look and feel younger too, on the outside.
And the next one we have, enlightening the spirit, connection to the pure source.
This is really good, and, you know, if you don't listen to anything else, this is one of those, this is the one thing that you need to listen to. In fact, I would listen to this first if you did, you know, get the package. Again, it's all up to you guys, but it really initiates that connection, and once that connection is made, or a stronger connection is made to that pure source, things just start to naturally happen. You attract things way beyond your dreams that will come in for you.
This is basically what you do, right, when you are working on people. You're helping them to connect to pure source and, you know, cleaning up stuff. But this is the starting point, right, the connection to the pure source.
Yes, this is the starting point. Yes, definitely.
And I think this is key. This is the most important thing, for sure, in my opinion.
yes.
Next one is financial abundance.
This CD is really powerful. We get a lot of fantastic testimonials on it. Again, it removes the frequencies of, you know, non-wealth, and then puts in frequencies. You know, just like Stephen Covey, he's got a fantastic book, 7 Habits of Successful People. Again, you know, instilling those, I believe they're more than 7 habits, but, you know, instilling that into you, all the frequencies of wealth. And then again, you start working or operating from those frequencies, and then you attract that wealth. It just naturally has to come in.
Absolutely. So this is something that, you know, for those of us on the call who are having abundance issues or blocks or money issues, you know, we could listen to this on a regular basis, and those things will start to shift, right?
Yes, definitely. And all these. Yes, I would suggest doing the meditations, and then, you know, we found fantastic results when people go to sleep with them at night. You know, they don't have to quite listen, but they put them on a loop, and it plays throughout the evening while they're asleep. You know, I get fantastic results. Well, some of our best testimonials are from people who've done that.
Wonderful. And then the last but not least, is the organic relationships.
Organic relationships. You know, have you ever found that, you know, you go from one relationship to another relationship to another relationship, and, it, you know, we change people, but, you know, the circumstances start to be the same. And that's because it's the frequency that we send out to attract those relationships. You know, those relationships are just patterns that we're sending out. If you're sending out, say, patterns of abuse, you're going to get somebody who abuses you. Mm-hmm. So we transform you into a higher, or what I call organic frequency in mm-hmm. relationships, and then you start attracting individuals, well, that'll help you ascend higher or become more complete.
So this is not just a matter of romantic relationship. It could be all sorts of different relationships. So, for example, if I wanted to attract more partners, you know, in my business, for example, then if my frequency has changed, then I'll be able to attract different types of partners, right? Business
yes.
partners or so on, right?
Yes,
so it's not just romantic relationship.
Any type of relationship.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is any type of relationship. Most people do use it for a romantic type, but you'll see your family relationships, you know, transform because you're transforming.
Right, yes.
Or your friends. You get better level of friends. Mm-hmm. Just as a word of caution, guys, if relationships are meant to break up, this just happens, it'll happen to you faster after listening to this meditation.
Faster and maybe with more ease.
Yes, with yeah. more ease, too.
Yeah, because sometimes, you know... Faster is good, but sometimes we want it to be easy, too, when there's other people involved, right?
Yes.
There's children involved and so on,
yes,
so you want it to be with ease. Yeah, wonderful. And you know, and this is all part of, you know, living to your fullest potential, living your best life, just, you know, living at, you know, from your core, from your source frequency that you truly are, and seeing that expression in the physical world, right?
Yes, definitely. Mm-hmm. That's what it's really about. It bypasses the physical realm, and you start seeing things from a higher value or a higher perspective.
And I love how there's like different types of MP3s for different areas of your life. So, you know, this one package is not just about abundance. It's not just about being happy. You know, it's about everything. You know, it's about relationships and abundance and connecting to source and anti-aging for those of us who are starting to get a little bit older, you know, and fear and just, you know, so many different areas in our lives where this can be of benefit. And it's a matter of listening to the meditation or listening to on a loop, you know, even that will start to shift things in our lives.
Yes, definitely.
And I like at the very end where it says, word of caution, for some, the paradigm shift may be too great. Do not take part if you are not ready for rapid change in your life. So, yes, be ready for rapid change. If that's what you want, you will get rapid change.
Hey, you know, people come up to me and they go, Moss, you know, I'm going through this detox. You know, that's because the rule sets you created, but maybe that's those things that you need to let go of before the good things start coming in.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where that came from.
Yeah. So yes, Regina responded back saying, "Hi, thank you. Yes, I felt I'm going to experience something this June. It'll flip my switch exponentially. Many hugs." Yeah. So she was on the call earlier. Wow. Thank you, Moss. This has been a great call. You know, we I'm feeling fantastic, and I'm sure the listeners are as well. And, you know, I always tell people, you know, go back to how when Moss is working on you, when he's talking to you or about you, because for the people on the Q&A, during that space, feel how you feel in that space and then reconnect to that so that you can continue to feel Moss's presence or the energy working just to, you know, so that because you are a conscious co-creator as well, right? So it's not just Moss doing the work. We are also creators of our own lives and responsible for those. So if you can do that, I think that would help to make it even stronger, I think. You know, it'll help to change it even
definitely.
More easily, right? If we're actually conscious of
yes.
it and just, I'll just let Moss do it, right?
Yeah, it's not that I do it for you guys. You get guided by your spirit. You know, I just kind of open that door for you,
mm-hmm.
and then you have to walk through and, you know, start transforming. And what I say always is just notice what you notice.
Mm-hmm.
You do get guided.
Yeah, so notice what you notice.
Involved. Yes.
Wonderful. Thank you, Moss. And I would tell everybody drink lots of water. You know, that will also help as well, right? I'm always so thirsty,
definitely.
And I'm always yawning during these calls because I'm processing, clearing, processing.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Any other last advice, Moss?
Last advice, guys, again, you are perfect the way you are. You know, we've just kind of been tarnished through our experiences. So, you know, just let your light shine through. You can do it on your own. I just help you do it faster. That's all.
Absolutely. Thank you. Shining from our harmonious, oh my goodness, I didn't write it down properly. Harmonious space.
Harmonious balance or something like that?
Yeah, it was a really good line. You'll have to go back and listen. So go back and listen, and if you could post it on my Facebook, that'd be great. So thank you, everyone. Thank you so much, Moss. It was it's always such a pleasure having you on our show. I will definitely meet you one day in person at one of your events, for sure. So thank you, everyone, and have a great day, and continue to live your life filled with joy, peace, love, and abundance.